Hello, Zero K fans, and welcome to Nanolaze at Dawn. I'm your host, ChadFury333, with another set of exhibition matches for you, starting out with a match between Flipstep and Anarchid on Onyx Cauldron. So let's get to it. This map has actually been updated recently, but I'm pretty sure the only update has been to things like sound quality, like adding in little rain sounds and a couple things like that. So overall, if you're familiar with this map, then it's pretty much the same, and if not, well, it's basically what you see here. You have everyone starts in the corners, and then this area over here gets taken fairly frequently. Over the southwest, you get most of the time, this is what's contested, the southwest. Northeast, someone will go for that. Usually it maintains control, but yeah, otherwise it pretty much splits along the diagonal. Anyway, Anarchid going for Clickybot Factory, Flipstep going for Amphib Factory, which I was surprised not to see the last time we watched this map, because this lake in the center makes everything work so much better for Amphib. And Hover as well. They both work a lot better with that. And, well, first engagement. First blood goes to the Amphib Factory, which is no surprise, because glaives don't work super well. And it looks like Anarchid switching over to Warriors and Scythes, which is pretty sensible. Although, Rocko's aren't a bad idea either. Warriors and Scythes both are definitely common choices. Because Warriors can just deal with Ducks. I mean, they are Riot units, although a little tricky. But with enough Warriors, it's no problem. You can deal with Ducks without issue. And Scythes, of course, because they can get close up, and the Ducks don't really have any chance to do anything before they get cut. So yeah, that is how this is going to go for the next little while. Flipstep doing a fair bit of damage. Maybe he won't just go that simply. At this point, if this Conjurer dies, this Conjurer is the big thing. And it is going to go down, so that's one Conjurer down. That gives Flipstep a major advantage for expansion later on. And Anarchid losing yet another Metal Extractor, so whatever economic advantage Anarchid had is gone. And Flipstep, they might be losing their Conch as well. There's a Glaive right here trying to get rid of it, or possibly able to get rid of it. There it is! We're going for the Metal Extractor. Is it going to go for the Conch? Yep, and that Conch is going down too, but at the same time, the Duck's going around the side of the base. So Anarchid getting attacked by Ducks, and the Conch is going down as well. So Flipstep and Anarchid both losing their early workers, but Flipstep with an economic advantage starting out of the gate. And yet another attack here, Flipstep being extremely aggressive. This might be a very short game at this rate. I don't see a whole lot of anything going out there, and Glaive getting stopped by Flipstep's Duck, so Anarchid right now in a very tight position. I mean, mostly because of the lack of any real expansion ability. It's not a big deal yet, but it will be in probably about 2 or 3 minutes, because actually, come to think of it, no, they're relatively even. The Conch is back. Conjurer's being built up, so Anarchid should be okay at rebuilding, but they are behind economically regardless. So that is still going to be tough. They're still going to have to deal with that, and it's still going to be something that will obviously slow things down a bit. At any rate, Flipstep continuing to assault, because why not? Why not, really? And really, at this point, they've been doing fine. Scythe, however, will be putting a possible stop to that. Might putting some fear of God into Flipstep's heart if it does attack, which it seems to be a little bit wary of doing so. Anarchid might be using that for a scouting purpose at the moment. I don't know, but I think Anarchid might want to actually instill some fear of God into these Ducks somehow, because right now Flipstep's probably thinking they're way ahead, and they'd be right. At least in terms of their current economy. It is mostly reclaim-based right now, so they're not wrong about being ahead, but they aren't that ahead yet. It's more just a matter of potential. And at this point, like I said, Anarchid not that far behind either. I mean, they did manage to kill the Conch. They are getting the Warriors up, so Ducks will have a harder time dealing with anything. And Flipstep appears to be trying to set up for the Northeast. Not really setting up the Southwest, though. The Southwest is actually getting approached by one of the Conjurers from Anarchid. So Anarchid's going to have to deal with that, and it's going to be a tricky thing. No doubt about it. So Anarchid right now is, well, actually not a bad position. Just, you know, setting up, dealing some damage. Overall, seems like it could work. It's just Anarchid needs to make sure that they turn this into money. Because Flipstep is they are consistently expanding right now. And that Scythe not able to do anything. Oh, that sucks. A bit of scouting going on, but nothing more. Anarchid, you need money. You need money bad. Like, really bad. Get something, please. He's managing to get rid of a Duck here or there, but not enough. The Northeast, however, is actually pretty open. So, Anarchid going for it. Quite heavily, actually. Conjurer and Commander over to the northeast. So that's about it, though. Southwest, there isn't much of anything over there. There's a radar tower to see if there's anything over to the southwest. Oh, there is a Conjurer. Never mind. Yes, so Conjurer to the southwest, Conjurer to the northeast. Anarchid is getting their economy up. A bit slower than Flipstip, though. It's getting up there, but Flipstip is way ahead, and energy as well. Anarchid's e-stalling. Flipstip with plenty of energy to work with, and also getting boys to counter the warriors, because that's what you do. And the Duck's in a wonderful position as well, right behind the warriors. This should actually get rid of the warriors, no problem. Then it won't render the boys entirely redundant, but... Oh, no, never mind. Yeah, that warrior's dead. The warrior at the bottom, however, they're actually pretty lucky. And Flipstip's commander taking a fair bit of damage. It's not going to go down, but that scythe is... Actually, you know what? It might... Oh, will go down! Never mind, two scythes there. Flipstip not focusing on getting rid of the scythes, losing their commander. So Flipstip's expansion to the southwest has been slowed. Not stopped completely, but has been slowed. And Anarchid taking the southwest as well. So there we go. That's hitbox views. Oh, was the commander not able to hit the scythe? Wow, that's... Oh, yeah, that was actually a patch for that just now. Shoot, yeah, that was actually a bug that's been fixed. That explains why that was a thing that was caught. That this game, apparently, was a problem with engineers not being able to shoot their own feet. Or at least shoot at their own feet. So yeah, at this point, Anarchid managing to get some momentum back into the game. Possibly due to hitbox abuse, but definitely due to killing important targets. And managing to successfully kill important targets. At any rate... Both are finally more even. No, Flipstep's still way ahead. I was about to say they're more even, but no, Anarchid's getting some reclaim, but that's about it. Flipstep taking the northeast, so Flipstep is going to get quite ahead economically. And the boys are in position, as well as a scallop for some reason. Not sure what that's going to be intended to achieve. Scallops are generally for if there were glaives, which there won't be because you have ducks on the field. Why would anyone go for glaives in this situation? I'd go for a Spectre in this situation, which... Makes a lot more sense, because the possibility of a grizzly is quite real. It's not happening, though. Flipstep doesn't really play like Kokomoko does. Flipstep's going heavy on the boys, heavy on the ducks, light on the grizzlies. I don't really see this changing up too much. I mean, the Spectre will help a bit. The Spectre will allow for getting rid of boys and getting rid of that scallop if it's a big concern. I mean, it'll get rid of units. That's not a problem. Anakin, however, going for the gunship plant... Bit of a risky strategy given that they only have 25 metal per second, but they could make it work. And Flipstep also going for that, but they have actually... very overdrive dependent who is ahead. They're both not in a great position for setting up a second factory right now, so that's going to be risky. The thing with Flipstep, though, is that Flipstep has a much more solid army. I mean, Anarchid has like two warriors, Spectre, and a couple scythes. Well, Flipstep has got almost half a dozen boys, a couple scallops. I've lost count of the number of ducks. Where's the ducks? Four ducks. Okay, it's not that many ducks. But still, they have a pretty decent army going forward. So they can deal with things. They're just not necessarily going to be able to deal with the things as effectively as... Well, okay, Anarchid's going to have a harder time. Anarchid is managing to get through. The Spectre is helping a lot. As long as the Spectre defends long enough that the gunship plant can pay off, then yeah, I guess. But Flipstep already with more money, already getting it up first. Going for pure Banshee, or sorry, Banshee Rapier, whereas Anarchid with a pure Banshee build. Sorry, pure Rapier build. That's not a Banshee. Pure Rapier build. And I gotta say, I can see why Flipstep's doing that. And I think it's gonna work out it's gonna work out early on. The Banshee should be okay. They should be able to get around, get rid of, you know, a handful of Lotuses here or there. Once the Rapiers get up for Anarchid, though, in large enough numbers, then it's gonna be a problem. Which is, of course, why Flipstep is going for the Rapiers afterwards. To go toe-to-toe. Or get Tridents. I think once either sees that the other is gone for air as well, we're going to see Tridents on the field. Possibly Anglers and Gremlins, but most likely just Tridents. And there's a Scallop doing something. Getting rid of a Scythe. I guess that makes sense. That's where you'd use it for, is to... A Scythe comes up to you, gets revealed, blow it away with a shotgun, and get blown away in turn by a sniper rifle. Are these scythes going to go to their deaths? No, they are not committing suicide. Or at least not unproductively committing suicide. That was important to commit suicide productively if you're going to commit suicide. Don't do it for nothing. Your life is a precious resource. Spend it wisely. Anyway, there's Well, the first couple rapiers coming up from Anarchid, and finally getting their... Wow. Bit overkill getting their energy situation back in order, but hey, it's back in order, so at least that's that. And where are those Banshees? They are... Only a couple rapiers up for Flipstep. The Banshees should be around here somewhere. Ah, there they are, going around the south side of the map. So Banshees going around the south side of the map. Some distraction over to the center to keep that from being very obvious, but I think Anarchid's going to notice it, because they have radar. And yes, they do. They will see it. If they're paying attention, they will definitely see that they have radar dots for those Banshees. Actually, how much does Flipstep know about where Anarchid is? Okay, they got complete knowledge. They can go wherever they'd like. Or near complete knowledge. At the same time, though, we do have Anarchid going up. They're aware that Flipstep's sending Banshees around the side, and the rapiers are going to be in place. They should be able to deal with them. And there's the fight. Going out there, one Banshee... Actually, no, that rapier's going to tank it, no problem. So yeah, the Banshee's already going down. Two Banshees down for basically free. And the other three have to escape. That's just a reclaim at this point. That's money. That is money for Anarchid for later. But Anarchid with the northeast, as well as taking quite a bit of the southwest, Anarchid's got a very healthy economic situation. It's really turned around. And after the opening harassment, I wasn't sure, but yeah, Anarchid's made up for it. At the same time, this is a bit of a tricky situation. This army does have to be destroyed, and Anarchid designed to bury themselves in a hole, which is prudent. I mean, they don't want to die. They don't have to. Oh, what? Oh, that's how it works. I did not realize that. So apparently, that's how underwater weapons work. It's not if the unit itself is underwater. It's if its target is underwater, and right now, Anarchid's commander is underwater right now. Thus, the mines, which if the scout gets close enough, will actually work. But it doesn't know how to aim, which is sad, because if it did, that would actually work nicely, just to lob some depth charges in there and blow up the commander. But thanks to their inability to aim, that commander gets to live. That's the one reason that commander gets to live, because honestly, that would have been brilliant. That would have worked out beautifully if it had worked out at all. But it didn't, so that sucks. Oh well, too bad. Same time though, Razor's up for Anarchid, so they know exactly what's going on. They obviously know what's going on. What answer do we have up though? Looks like none. Looks like we're just seeing rapier wars. They figure, well, I have more rapiers. Maybe. I don't know. I think they're actually pretty even. We have eight. Yeah, we have eight for Flipstep and nine for Anarchid. Sorry, nine for Flipstep, eight for Anarchid. So it's not like, oh, actually, this is not working out for the ground army at all. Good timing though. Oh, good positioning. That's the one thing though. This ball of rapiers here from Anarchid is all nice and together, but Flipstep with the trident, so we will have these rapiers going away. Anarchid still, that ground army is not doing too well. I mean, if Flipstep were to combine the rapiers and their tridents, they'd be able to get rid of the ground army, no problem, and Anarchid wouldn't be able to answer that at all. Or not easily, anyway. Right now, though, it looks like the main focus is on building up a much larger ground army. No gremlins, surprisingly. The warriors kind of make sense if there were more Banshees, but there are no gremlins, and down goes the commander. Thought they could get out of there, thought they could escape. Well, I mean, they thought they were no longer in any peril, and then died. That sucks. But at the same time, we still have more harassment coming in from this sides here over the eastern side of the map, and what else is Anarchid up to? Anarchid's really got to deal with, like, this is the army here is the problem. They've got to deal with this. They can't easily deal with it with air, or they have to just go for it and sacrifice a couple rapiers to get rid of both tridents. That might be the best option. Otherwise, Flipstep's just going to be able to advance slowly but surely, and once they get close enough to getting rid of this, I mean, the ground army, the ducks just get into here, kill off the Razor is no problem. And after that, there's not much that stops the southwest from being taken down. Well, I don't really know. I think Anarchid's still getting the upper hand here. And these sides are doing work. Getting rid of the eastern side here, probably gonna get rid of this metal extractor if they decide to. At least possibly taking the northeast again. With Flipstep over the boys in the north, and got a pretty broad army, but now it's actually not working out again. And gremlins are up. They might help. I mean, the boys are gonna definitely try to put a stop to that. So north side, we have Flipstep taking a bit more. Anarchid's still way ahead economically. So Anarchid's still got a very nice position to work from. It's just a matter of what they're gonna do with that. And they are going for Strider Hub. I was about to say, if they go for a Strider Hub, are they gonna go for a Strider Hub? And yes, they are. Which, I mean, seems like a pretty obvious option, but it's also a fairly strong one. Or at least a fairly reliable one, more to the point. There are several strong options, but Strider Hub is a reliable one. Get a Dante or a Scorpion, and then just go for it. It should, well, 15 seconds left. Not sure what it'll build, but hey, that should be fine. Now look at the Rapiers to get rid of the boys, which will... That'll stop the entire assault on the north side. In fact, that will cause the north side to be opened enough that it should be pretty much just a matter of then getting more workers in there. Build up again. Because there's really not much else to do. Like, just build up, and once this is done, I mean, this wasn't a super profitable fight. Boys have a bit of an easier time getting rid of Rapiers than the other way around, but there are enough Rapiers, so no big deal. How many Rapiers do they have? 16 Rapiers right here alone! Wow, that's been a lot of investment. And what are we getting? We're getting a Dante, which makes all the sense in the world because that's what everyone gets all the time. Except for when they get Scorpions, or occasionally Funnel Webs. But it's usually Dante's. And more sides just waiting around. Ooh! What? Oh, was that... I couldn't tell if that was a forced attack there. I think the Rapiers might have been guessing there were scythes right there and guessed wrong, but still, interesting guess. I think Flips is trying to screen the ground from the air using the Rapiers. And yes, that actually... I think that might work because... Rapiers do fly quite low to the ground. So I think they actually fly low enough to get to the decloak radius of scythes. I'm not sure. Well, could be. I actually never really checked that one. That'd be a good thing to test, if Rapiers can actually decloak scythes. I think they can, but I'm not sure. Anyway, north side again with more construction. I mean, Anarchid just, they want to get that economy solid so that if they don't make that Dante work, at least it's not everything. Well, that's taking a really long time. It's a bigger reason to try to get everything set up for economy is they want to get their bloody Dante up before the game's over. I mean, I say that as if there's some time limit on the game, but it could be over if it's not, that's not up fast enough. I mean, Flip-Tip is still building up and they're not building Striders. They aren't gambling on that. They're still investing most of their forces or most of their money into their main force. And that is the opening Flip-Tip. I mean, Flip-Tip, they attack right now. That's a pretty good timing. Other than the Rapiers, there isn't much that Anarchid has. Anarchid's a bit ahead economic or militarily. Actually, no, they're about even militarily. They're ahead economically. It hasn't really translated in large part because that Dante is eating up a lot of money. But that's the thing, is that once that Dante is done, then it's going to be different. But right now there's a bit of an opening. This is about the only time Flipstep has before everything falls apart. And they're doing the Anglers too, so getting rid of the Rapier shouldn't be a problem. No further Tridents from the looks of it though. There were the two that were built and I don't see them. Yeah. And the Gremlin's already in place, so at this point, I mean, Flipstep unsurprisingly taking the center lake. Anarchid also unsurprisingly trying to just take everything around the lake because I want to have some control over that. Actually, why are they there? They can't really do much, and the Gremlins are all going to die. Granted, there's not like scallops or anything in the water, so it's not like it's hard to get rid of, but still. Oh, nice. Urchins on the coast. I like it. That's a clever idea. That's really nice. Just use that to get rid of everything inside the lake. Control the lake from the coast. Forcing the anglers out of position as well. Actually, getting them out of the lake, really, that's the goal. Mission accomplished. Well done, Anarchid. Of course, now it's just a matter of making sure that everything's under Anarchid's control. And a lot of fast building, getting up a lot of economy, which is what they need. Primarily. The Dante, still a lot of work going on that. That'll be a little while. Yeah, Anarchid's pretty much just closed that timing window. Flipstep has no easy way of getting back in here, so Flipstep, not sure what they're going to do right now. Anarchid also with 22 Rapiers going around the back. All right, Flipstep's got some defenses there. 16 Rapiers of their own and a Razor. Two Razors. There it goes. Wondering where the other one was. I'd figure there'd be two, and the Tridents as well, so it's not going to be unopposed. But it will be a distraction, and that distraction might be just enough to allow the ground army to get in, because the Rapiers were the big problem for this ground army. So with those Rapiers distracted, there's nothing really stopping the warriors from getting in and just killing everything. I mean, this might be a sacrifice on Anarchid's part, although I think at this point this... No, it's not. This is working out beautifully for Anarchid. Managing to pull Flipsip's own rapiers away from their base, which also makes it harder to reclaim them, because their corpses are going to be strewn across the mountain range rather than conveniently inside of Flipsip's base. So reclaim is going to be a pain. And yeah, just hanging out here. And like I said, that distraction sort of paid off, allowed the warriors to get some movement in here. I mean, not much, but hey, it's something. And with, okay, Grizzly up. Kind of missed that. Like, Grizzly's not really doing a whole lot, though, yet. It's doing a bit of damage, but it's not going to be a big deal. And the rapier should be able to get rid of it, no problem. Although, they got to make sure not to be close together, otherwise they might get shot out of the sky like that. Actually, in combination, but yes, that's not working out at all. How many that was 22 rapiers. Now there's, like, 10. If they're not careful, there'll be more like 2. And the Dante is just about done, so when that's done, that might turn things around, but Flipsip's not... They're not going to go down easy, that's for sure. There's nothing to say that's going to happen, and I seriously doubt it would anyway. This is going to be a bit more of a slog. And yeah, that's actually a good thing to point out, is Sprang pointing out in the chat that Clokies are beating Amps here. That's new! I mean, Clokies, I would say, if like a 6-4, maybe 7-3 matchup against Amps, although I have also mentioned that early in the match, early game, Cloaks have a harder time, but that's because Glaives don't do well against Ducks. Anarchid built 2 Glaives and then switched to Warriors for the rest of the game. So Anarchid just played the matchup properly. Like, the typical way you play Clokiebot, yes, Amphib just wrecks it. But Clokiebot has strategies that can beat Amphib. They're just not what you typically do against other factories. So that's really more what it is. It's not so much hard for Clokey as just different for Clokey. At the same time, though, there go all the tridents. So, hey, air is opened up again. Go for it, Anarchid. You can just kill everything. Although, unfortunately, losing all the gremlins in the or possibly losing all the gremlins in the process, the Dante is there to help support, but I don't know if it's going to be helping out. I mean, it's going to possibly just burn up all the... Yeah, that's exactly what's going to happen. It's going to burn up all of the gremlins. So the Dante doesn't really save them. It sort of just kills everything. I figured that was going to happen. Of course, the real test is getting through the Grizzly. If it gets through the Grizzly, no problem, then that is going to be game. I think Anarchid will take it. But at the same time, there's a lot of resistance. I mean, there's the rapiers, which... Well, never mind, actually. No, Flipsip's done. I mean, I thought, oh, there's the rapiers, all 3 of them. 2 of them now. Forgot that most of them had died thanks to that earlier attack, so never mind. And also thanks to the gremlins. I thought they just got rid of the tridents, but apparently I was wrong. So 14 rapiers on top of Dante once it gets repaired. Where is the... Are there no conjurers coming in? Okay, there's the conjurer coming in. But no, not much resistance. Flipsip's pretty much lost everything here. They've lost a lot of territory. They got a lot of reclaims. So they're keeping up... They're not falling behind that far economically, but they are falling behind economically. There's no doubt about it. They are having a hard time. And they know this is definitely a last stand, but they don't have much to get rid of this with. Handful of tridents and a brawler to help get rid of the rapiers, but really that's the distraction. The Dante is kind of the main story here, but at the same time, the Grizzly, Flipsip's Grizzly trying to get rid of the Dante while the Dante is weak before the Conjurer really gets, actually, Conjurer, where'd the Conjurer go? I think the Conjurer died. Because there should have been Conjurer there, and I imagine there was at one point a Conjurer there, and there's no Conjurer there anymore. Okay, there's the Conjurers. There's the repair. But yeah, that Dante needs to get repaired, because otherwise that Flipsip's Grizzly will wreck it. And even as it is, Flipsip's Grizzly is still going to be a threat. The Rapier support will help, but it still will be it'll be a hard thing to get rid of. Although 16 Rapiers all being distracted by Tridents, all being forced away by Tridents. Flipsip is getting a possible comeback opportunity. They've got to get rid of the economy, though. Like, militarily, they're close enough. It's really tough, because if they go over to the southwest, they open up the center lane, or the northeast, either way. They don't have enough units that can really attack much. They have the brawlers, which they'll probably use for harassing the northeast a bit, because the northeast is not set up for dealing with air. The southwest has a couple, has like 5 razors, so... No, 2 of them are under construction. It has 4 razors. So the southwest isn't really an option for brawlers. The northeast, however, yeah, that could actually work. It'd be a bit tricky. There are still gremlins. There's still some anti-air, but it's an option. At the same time, there's scythes coming in here, which don't do much. That's the thing. The scythes at this rage, at this stage in the game, aren't really going to help out too much. Brawlers are going to be... Oh, sheesh. These conjurers need to live. Flipstiff, no, what are you doing? Anakin, what are you doing? Don't let those conjurers die. Save them. And all but two of them go down. That's gonna hurt. I don't think it'll completely ruin the game for Anarchid, but it's gonna be tough. That's gonna make it difficult to deal with. Because at this point, Grizzly with about 7,500 health compared to a Dante with 6,000. And the Dante deals damage, but it's not huge. It's a lot of damage over time. It's not a lot of direct damage, but the second Dante is in there, so never mind. Anarchid should be able to power through. The first Dante about to go down, but the second Dante should have no problem dealing with everything else. Yeah, first Dante goes down thanks to the Grizzly, but the second Dante there to make up for it, there to finish the job, there to ideally not die, and there to win the game pretty much. So Anarchid, congratulations for winning in what most people consider to be a highly disfavorable matchup. Area damage and damage over time. That's the two big things. Second Dante, however, has gone down as well, so Flipstep may actually not be out completely yet. It's just economically very difficult for Flipstep to get back in here. It's more trying to break Anarchid's economy as they have right now. That's the problem. I thought those Dantes were going to take it, though. There just wasn't enough support from Anarchid. But now here's the support. Better late than never. Well, not really, actually. That's just going to get themselves killed as the Tridents wreck the rape. What the heck? Anarchid, no, you're gonna... Why are you letting your rapiers die? That was like five rapiers in 2 seconds. Well, the rest of them going down too. I guess they figure they want to join their brethren or try their best. They want to commit suicide productively. Well, they certainly succeeded. They got rid of a wasp and all died. Well, almost all died. And there's no anti-air back here as well, so the Tridents could just continue chasing if they'd like. They really don't have to go back. But no, it looks like Flipstep... I mean, they're economically broken. So really it's just a matter of time before Anarchid just rebuilds or builds a bunch of new things or gets an airplane factory and then goes with that or gets a crow or I don't know what. They have a lot of options right now. They have a lot of money. They have a lot of excess. They're not using that money. How are they e-stalling and metal excessing at the same time? Oh, right, repair, that's why. Wait, what are they repairing? Everything they repair is dead. Well, okay, that's a bizarre thing to have happen, but yeah, it looks like having a bit of trouble with silencer, really? Okay, fine. That's a thing. I don't know if that'll work. Anarchid's way ahead, so they almost might as well, but sheesh. Silencer? Really? I mean, I guess that's money. It's money they're spending on a thing. It's just money they're spending on a thing that won't pay off for like three minutes or so. I'm about to say 3 days, because that's about as long as it feels, but this might just end in a surrender. Flipstep might just leave before the nukes drop. I just don't even. And there goes the last of Flipstep's possible raiding forces with that scallop gone down. Yeah, the silencer. That's a thing. Hey, honestly, it could just be a crow. Let's just speed that up a bit, though. That's going to take a little while, and I don't think there's a whole lot Flipstep's going to do. Actually, never mind! I say that right as I say that. Flipstep actually does go for it, but... No, that's... What? Silencer in the middle of the map... Or not silencer, Screamer in the middle of the map as well. Why not just get rid of all the air forces that Flipstep might throw out? Because that's a thing. I don't think the silencer is going to get done before the game's... Before the game just gets called. I think Flipstep's just going to GG as soon as the Grizzly dies. And hey, glaives! Haven't seen those in a while. How about that? Remember when glaives were a thing? Well, they're back. And they're dead again. They were gone for a reason. Thanks, Stardust. You're actually... Whoa, no, never mind! The glaive's managing to use the Grizzly as cover! Well, that works out beautifully. I thought they were dead, but nope. line of sight mechanics. That's how you win in this game. That's seriously how you win in engagements like that in this game, is abusing line of sight mechanics and using your enemy's units as cover from their own ability to shoot you. No, looks like Firewalker's going to be coming up, though. Jump ship plant coming up immediately. And indeed, Firewalker, Sumo. Yep, that's what you go for. You get the jump bot factory when you're dealing with defenses for the Firewalker, because it's awesome at clearing defenses. So that's really the move to go for. And that silencer, I don't even know. I mean, it's getting 30 metal per second, but it's not going to get done anytime soon. So at this point, Flipstip, are you doing anything? Can you do anything? The air is completely wrecked. You got cloaks around all sides. I mean, Anakin's got this obvious contain. I think Flipstip's probably figured by now there's something going on. Like, some kind of thing, some kind of BM. Actually, they could reclaim the mountains, come to think of it. The wasps would allow them to do that. But yeah, that's going to be... I don't think they're going to let themselves go that far. And the silencer... Well, it's almost done. It's a thing, but it's going to take another 3 minutes afterwards. Like, this is going to be a matter of... Oh! Mel's Infernos as well, so... Yeah. Get that missile silo as well on top of that. Just this entire fire base in the front. Just, it's like big team games in the middle of a 1v1, because why not? Anarchy's got the massive economic advantage. They might as well go for it. Might as well piss Flipstip off for the rest of their day. In something, I guess. What are they waiting for? I mean, Flipstip's gonna be throwing in the towel any time now. I don't think they have... I'm pretty sure they're aware they can't really get through this. They don't have that much money, and they're losing their entire main base to fire. Even if they're not aware the silencers are coming up, they're probably well aware that there's no way out of this. No easy way, anyway. I don't think there's anything they could easily build. I mean, I guess they could also go for missile silo themselves. But I don't see them doing that. They're not in a position where they're likely to go for buildings to solve their problems. They're going for units. And that's how you solve your problems when you're in this situation. Or that's how you typically solve your problems, is by going for more units. And the silencer's done, so hey, that's a thing. I don't think it'll matter, but it's done. So hey, in 3 minutes time, or 1 minute, because we're sped up. Nah, these guys are gonna finish it off. Flipstip's gonna throw in the towel right now. Well, good try at burning all the glaives up. And they should go down. Not quickly enough. Never mind. They're not gonna go down at all. Flipstip's not even gonna survive this. This is gonna be GG. A lot of factories, though. Just trying anything. Trying impalers, trying firewalkers, getting another grizzly. This, however, is gonna do it. There's the GG. That's game. That's it. And hey, it's be another minute and a half, and there would have been a nuke. Nope. I don't know if I think Flipstip must have realized afterwards yet that wasn't taking a while. That was, I'm waiting for a nuke. I'm gonna nuke you in like 10 minutes. Which actually be really horrifying to think if someone actually said that in real life, come to think of it. Anyway, gonna be moving on after that long slog of a game to a slightly shorter slog of a game. Or impossible slog of a game. Don't know. Anyway, it's going to be 400 versus GoGo Dancer on Titan Duel. So stay tuned for that. It'll be up in just a moment.